This morning on the bus, there was a woman carrying a bag with inspirational sayings and positive affirmations on it, which I was reading because I'm a fan of inspirational sayings and positive affirmations. I also like clothing that gives you advice. What's kinder than the baseball cap of a stranger telling you what to strive for? It's like living in a world of endless therapists. The inspirational bag of the woman on the bus said a bunch of stuff like, live in the moment and remember to breathe. But it also said children are the orgasm of the world. Are children the orgasm of the world like orgasms are the orgasms of sex? Are children the orgasm of anything? Children are the orgasm of the world like silence is the orgasm of the telephone, or shit is the orgasm of the lasagna, or hovercraft are the orgasm of the future. You could even say that sheep are the orgasm of lonely pastures, which are the orgasm of modern farming practices, which are the orgasm of the Industrial Revolution. And then I thought, why not? I like comparing things to other things too. Like sometimes when we're having sex, and you look like a helicopter in a low-budget movie, disappearing behind a cloud to explode. Or an athlete winning a prestigious international sporting tournament at the exact moment he discovers his wife has just been kidnapped. For the most part, orgasms are the orgasms of the world. Like slam dunking a glass basketball, or executing a perfect dive into a swimming pool full of oh my god. Or travelling into the past to forgive yourself and creating a time paradox so complex it forces all of human history to reboot, stranding you naked on some distant and rocky outcrop, looking up at the sunset from a world so new, looking up hasn't even been invented yet.